Dear amiable viewers, today we're going to continue with our series on Cisco router configuration, step by step, part 2. And we're going to call this one securing the router. Basically, what we're going to implement in here is called Cisco NFP, which stands for Network Foundation Protection. If you are a beginner in Cisco world, you most probably might ask, what is that? Well, Cisco NFP or Network Foundation Protection is a framework which provides infrastructure protection based on IOS features designed specifically to protect the device control plane, services and routing protocols, the device data plane, malicious traffic, and the device management plane. In other words, this configuration will protect our router. If you have viewed our previous video, you most probably might know that our router has no configuration on it, so we're going to have to start from scratch and step by step reach where we want to go. So our first step on this configuration is setting up the host name. Alright folks, so right now we are in user exec mode. To get from this mode into the privilege mode, we need to write enable. And once we enter into the privileged mode, we want to go into the global configuration mode to be able to configure the router. Okay, we are in. Right now we are configuring the hostname. And as you can see, it's very simple. You just write hostname and the name of the hostname that you want it to be. In this case, we wrote Ameble. We're done with that. Now we continue with securing our passwords by encrypting them so that they cannot be seen in the config file. Okay, service password encryption. We're done with that. We do enable secret and we leave secret pyro. Now we create a username. Simply we create a user. So let's name it Chloe, and the privilege level that this user will have is 15, that's the highest privilege, and the secret is going to be Stella. Once we're done with that, we continue by configuring SSH. SSH stands for Secure Shell, and the first step that we need to do is add an IP domain name. You can see we did ameble.local. Then we create a crypto key generator. We simply generate the crypto key. So we're being asked if we want to replace the existing ones, and we do yes. Then we're being recommended if we want 512, and we write manually 1024 because that's more secure. And we go IP, SSH, version 2, that's the newest SSH version. We go IP SSH authentication, so that authentication retries, so that the number of retries that someone can try to log in through SSH will be 3. After that, they will be not allowed to try for another 120 seconds. Then we continue with the line VTY. Line VTY is the virtual line, terminal line. So we do line VTY 0 to 4. Login local, transport input SSH, exec timeout 3. Exit. Once we're done with that, we do the line console 0. That's how we are logged in right now, as we are configuring this router. We log in local, exec timeout 3, same as for the virtual line. Once we're done with that, we go and we create a banner. So if someone tries to log in, we will see a message that we will write right now. Do not even try. All right. We're done with this part. Now we block the login. The 10 attempts. Three within 20 seconds. Okay. Login on failure log, login on success log, and that's it. Okay, so we exit from the privileged mode, but before that we do copy running config to startup config so that we save the configuration file. We'll be right back.